guys, welcome to this video over systems of equations. A system of equations is a group of two or more equations, and each of the equations within the group have an unknown variable. When given a system of equation, the goal is to find the value for each of the unknown variables. In this video, we will discuss two tools to help you solve for the unknown variables, substitution and elimination. Substitution is a way of solving the system by getting rid of all of the variables except for one, then solving for that equation. The best time to use substitution is when you have a variable that has a coefficient of 1 or negative 1. The reason why is because if it has a coefficient of 1 or negative 1, then you don't need to undo multiplication or division. You just need to undo addition or subtraction in order to isolate a variable. There are three steps that you need to follow in order to be able to solve the system using substitution. First, you need to solve for your x and y in one equation. Then, you need to plug your x or y in that you solve for into the other equation, then solve. Then lastly, use the number that you get when you solve to solve for the other variable or variables, depending on how many equations that you have. So let's get started. In this example, we can see that our second equation has a variable with 1 as the coefficient. So that lets us know to solve for x. Now, you can actually solve for any of the variables. It will just always be easier to solve for one that has a coefficient of 1 or negative 1. Now, to do this, we just add 9y to both sides. So we've done what our first step tells us to do, and we solved for one of our variables. Step two now tells us to plug in the variable that we have solved for into our other equation, then solve. So we're gonna plug our x into our 4x plus 3y equals to 2. Because we know that x is equal to 9y minus 19, we'll plug this into our x value here, and then solve. Now that we have it down to one variable, we are able to solve for the value of that variable, so in this case, y. Let's rewrite this by multiplying our 4 by everything inside our parentheses. Now we can add our 76 to both sides. You can do this multiple ways. If you wanted to add your y's together first, then do that. I'm just doing what is easier in my mind. Once I add my 76 to both sides, and add my y's together, I get 39y is equal to 78. Now I divide both sides by 39. Use the number that you get when you solve to solve for the other variable or variables. So now all we have to do is take our y value and plug it into one of our original equations. And it doesn't matter which one, you can plug it into the first or the second, but I'm gonna plug it into the second equation just because. So that gives you x, and this is our original one right here. So that's x minus 9 times 2 is equal to negative 19. And we're done. We have found the value of both of our variables using substitution. Now, let's take a look at how to solve for a system using elimination. The reason this tool is called elimination is because you add together the two equations in order to eliminate one of your variables. Look at this example. We can tell just by looking at it that our y's will cancel out. So once we add the two equations together, we have, and we can divide both sides by 10. We can take our x value and plug it into either of our original equations. I'll plug it into our first one here. So we have, and then I'll rewrite this. This is 9 as. Now we need to move our 9 to the other side by subtracting 9. Then we divide both sides by our negative 4 here. So now we've solved and we found both of our variables. That was a good example to learn how elimination works, but it may not always be that our terms cancel out so easily. Like in this example. None of our terms cancel off right off the bat, so we'll need to do a little manipulation in order to get them to do what we want them to do. So, what can we do to get our terms to cancel? Well, there are a couple of things, but the easiest, as it appears to me, is to multiply our first equation by 2. That will allow us to cancel our y's because we'll be adding a negative 6 and a positive 6. So, let's do that. We have this equation all being multiplied by 2. So let's rewrite that and we get. Now we need to take this and add it to our other equations so we can get our y's to cancel out. So that would give us. Now we need to divide both of our sides by 20, which gives us negative 4. So now that we know that x is equal to negative 4, we can plug in our negative 4 where our x's are in either one of our original equations. I'll plug it into the second one. So we have, and I'll simplify this and rewrite it. Now I'll move and add my y to both, or add my 8 to both sides. So you get 8. Now I divide both sides by 6 here. So our final answer for this problem is x is equal to negative 4 and y is equal to 7. I hope that this video on how to solve a system of equations using substitution and elimination has been helpful. For further help, be sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking below. See you guys next time.